So, I'm here myself based on a visit that was paid to some by some city council members and members of the community last Thursday, exactly a week ago. And we had a conversation about Eid, Muslim holiday. And when this information came to us, it initially came to us on the 3rd of September in an email. And the date for the holiday was the 23rd in the email that I got. And that got clarified the night of the meeting, that it was the 24th. And then when I had speakers come up, one after the other, expressing their opinions about the holiday, I don't know how this got lost in the conversation and how we conducted the meeting, but a lot of people don't come to the caucus meeting, so a lot of times information is not always shared and transferred over. And I know there was some sort of displeasure on that Tuesday night. But when it came down to Thursday, we had already laid out all the reasons why we couldn't do a closure of the entire school system at the last minute with only 6 days' notice, after we had already revised the calendar on September 1st and posted it on our Facebook page. It made absolutely no sense to have parents try to make a short term and try to make arrangements for their children. Now, I laid all this information out. I don't know who all stayed to hear it all, because, you know, there was a lot of yelling, a lot of, you know, other things going on, and people wanted what they wanted. But they didn't understand the ramifications of the decision that we would have made. And I tell you for a fact that I look at everything, and I have to make sure that all children are being considered here, which the majority of our children in the district would have been impacted by a school closure. Now, I don't know what went on here, because I heard there was a vote and with you guys, and you know, I think some members of the council were here, and the superintendent was supposedly here. I don't know, I'm just hearing this. But my thing is, I'm not going to get something last minute and be asked to make a decision on something when I know that I'm making the right decision. And I don't like the fact that I'm being asked to do something that the council has not been willing to do themselves, because tonight is the night of the holiday, and I don't understand why I'm being asked to close down the schools, that business is being conducted right here and now on the day of the holiday that we were asked to close our schools. It makes absolutely no sense. Now, I know it was moved because the Jewish holiday was yesterday, but we moved it to the Muslim holiday. I don't understand that. I don't understand it at all. It makes absolutely no sense to me.
I'm here speaking on my own behalf, not as representative of the Jersey City School Board. I'm here to discuss a vote taken by the Jersey City Council on September 9th regarding closing the schools today in honor of Eid al-Adha. If I said it wrong, I apologize. I was here in the evening that you voted on this issue. It was very surprising that you voted this without putting the necessary thought into the outcome of your vote. To help you understand why I voted against closing our entire district, I want to shed some light on the topic. The Jersey City School District has approximately 29,000 students, with approximately 4,500 students with special needs, and over 10,000 students below grade 6. Closing all schools may require their parents or guardians to get coverage for them or take the day off work, possibly causing undue hardship. We deal with a large number of students who receive free or reduced cost meals. Closing the school would mean that these students would have no access to 2 meals per day, possibly even that they would eat. We offer both Morning Stars and CASPER programs. Morning Stars allows parents to drop their children off at 7 a.m., and CASPER allows the students to stay until 6 p.m. Closing the schools would prevent parents from using these morning and evening programs, again, forcing them to find coverage so that they can go to work. CASPER also provides an after-school snack and a dinner, both of which would not be served. Closing the schools schools would affect the salaries of the hundreds of our local residents that work part-time and per diem, and only get paid when they go to work. Cutting the day, for example, our subs make $18,000 a year, $100 daily. Cutting a day from their salary at a week's notice might affect their ability to purchase food or fully pay their rent. A comment was made in their school board meeting that we should respect all religions and honor a state-approved religious excuse holidays. Did anyone on this council research the number of days that the state has approved or even reviewed the State Department of Education's policy on religious approved excuse days? In 1 year, over the 365 days, the state has approved approximately 150 days that the students can take off for excused religious holidays. They also provide very strict guidelines on how they are to address the students who choose to take off for religious reasons, protecting their rights and respecting their religious views. This is the law, with an additional provision that any district may add days as deemed necessary. The school calendar was voted on and approved in May. It was handed out to our entire district a week before our caucus meeting. Our district reports that we have approximately 44 languages spoken at the homes of our students. How could we possibly ensure that every student from every school received and understood the change to the calendar that was given to them a week earlier? How many young students might have shown up to school to find it closed and have to figure out what to do? Moving forward into the school year, how do we address any other religious group that comes to us and requests the district to be closed for religious reasons? If we voted to approve one group and then turned down another, we'd be setting ourselves up for possible lawsuits. I agree that the calendar needs to reflect our diverse community. I agree that we need to honor all the religions represented in our city, commonly referred to as the most diverse city in America. I want to see a calendar that embraces our cultures and makes our students know that we respect everyone. I firmly believe that the current members of the school board make this happen, but it has to happen with thought and planning and an opportunity for all stakeholders to be at the table. There is more to this issue than just closing the district for the day. Communication issues, dietary concerns, fostering a respectful environment, and working together with the various cultures need to be priorities. We need to show our community that we embrace our differences and we live together as one community, albeit with different views. I am respectfully requesting that the City Council members discuss the ramifications of your votes when they concern our children. Please listen to those that have come before you, but also think that those who have not, for whatever reason, maybe didn't have the chance to tell you how their vote would affect them. I have asked that we address this issue at a special meeting we are scheduling in October. If we begin the process now, I'm hoping that the school board members will have ample time to meet with the community and build a strong foundation for an educational system that reflects our community and exudes respect. I am also hopeful that, instead of this closing a window on needed communications between the City Council and the school board, we have opened a door showing the need for all of us to work together. Thank you very much.
Thank you.